Good morning to all of you. Visibility audibility is great. Give me a thumbs up in the chat box. Those who are listening, please give me a thumbs up in the chat box so I can start it. Please fast. Thank you. Thanks for confirmation. So I welcome you all for today's session. A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Priyanka Sachdev here, NEET PG educator on an academy. And today I am here to teach you virology. We have already covered general virology yesterday. And today I will start with DNA viruses and try to finish it today only. So I will be a little bit faster today. Yes, so I'm starting with DNA viruses. Just a second. So I'm starting with DNA viruses. In DNA viruses, we know the classification of DNA viruses. So without wasting time, I'm just starting DNA viruses. So we know there are six DNA viruses, right? What are the six DNA viruses? Double H, A, triple P. You know these six are. That is Hepatna, Herpes, Adeno, the three PR, Parvo, Papova, and Pox. So I will teach you all six, one by one. So we will start with Pox first. After Pox, we will come on Adeno. After Adeno, we will come on Parvo. After Parvo, we will come on Papova. Then we will come on Herpes. The Hepatna part I will take with RNA viruses. Because in Hepatna, we have only, here we have only Hepatitis B. Rest of the Hepatitis are RNA viruses. So we will cover all Hepatitis together. I will take a separate lecture on Hepatitis virus. So I will cover five viruses here today. So I'm starting with the first virus, Pox virus. Okay, before starting it, these are the viruses. Just give me a second. Let me use the eraser. I would like to tell you general things and then I will start one by one the viruses with a common heading, and I ask all of you to make a comparative table between all of them. If you make a comparative table now, it will be very easy for you people. So which among them is the smallest and which among them is the largest? You already know Pox is the largest. Not only DNA virus largest, overall the largest virus is Pox virus, we know that. And smallest virus is Parvo virus is smallest virus overall B and then DNA B. So that is the smallest and largest. Which among them? These are DNA viruses, no? So all of them are double-stranded except Parvo, which is single-stranded. Rest all are double-stranded. So only Parvo is single-stranded. So that is single-stranded and double-stranded. Their duplication of all of them, these are DNA viruses, no? Their duplication takes place in nucleus. Except Pox virus, whose duplication takes place in cytoplasm, rest all duplication takes place in nucleus. Or kya hota hai iske alawa envelope, non-envelope. So which among them are enveloped? Which among them are non-enveloped? So three are enveloped, three are non-enveloped. So let me tell you which three are non-enveloped. It's Parvo. Parvo is non-enveloped. Papova, it is non-enveloped, and Adeno, PAP. These three are non-enveloped. Rest three are enveloped. Rest three, herpes, Hepatna, and Pox. Are enveloped. We know about it. So smallest, largest ho gaya, double stranded, single stranded ho gaya, nucleus, cytoplasm, duplication ho gaya, envelope, non-envelope ho gaya. What else? Symmetry. What about symmetry? All of them have icosahedral symmetry except Pox virus, which have complex symmetry. Helical kisi ki bhi nahi hoti hai. There are three types of symmetry. Na? Helical symmetries of RNA viruses. Give me a thumbs up. That was the general, just a revision of the general. So if you know this, I will start with DNA viruses. I'm starting with the first virus, Pox virus. Pox virus. So this, we have already discussed the general things. These are the six viruses. I'm starting the largest one, Pox virus. So Pox virus, I'm starting. I suggest you to make a comparative table using these headings of all five viruses, which I'm going to teach you today, all six viruses. So first virus is the Pox virus. Second virus will be the adenovirus. The third virus will be the parvovirus. The fourth virus will be the papova. The fifth virus will be herpes. Herpes mein I will teach you eight viruses. All eight viruses of herpes one by one. The most important will be variola, vaccinia. So one by one we will take all eight viruses of herpes, HSV, right? HSV1, HSV2, like this. So this is the comparative table. In what headings you have to compare each virus? So first you have to tell me the morphology of each virus. In morphology, you have to tell me five things about each virus. What are those five things? First, you tell me the shape. If there is any specific shape of that virus, you have to tell me that. Then you have to tell me the genetic material, whether it is DNA or RNA. Although all these viruses are DNA, so genetic material will be DNA. But we have to write what is the genetic material. After that, whether it is enveloped or non-enveloped. I have already told you which among them are enveloped, which among them are non-enveloped. So which is enveloped, which is non-enveloped, that you have to tell me the third thing. The fourth thing which you have to tell me is the symmetry. So all of them have icosahedral symmetry except the first virus, Pox virus, which has a complex symmetry. And the last fifth thing is replication. Replication in cytoplasm or nucleus. So all of them have replication in nucleus except Pox virus, which has replication in cytoplasm. And except pox have complex symmetry, rest all have icosahedral symmetry. So I'm starting with pox virus. So first thing you have to tell me is the morphology, then the classification of pox. Pox viridae is a family. Pox viridae is a family. इसमें कितने viruses आते हैं? You have to enumerate them. So classification, reservoir, mode of transmission, route of transmission, pathogenesis, after entering in the body, how, what, where the virus is going, how it is causing disease. Name the diseases caused by the virus along with its symptoms. So that is diseases. Lab diagnosis. Yesterday, those who have attended my yesterday's lecture also, they know lab diagnosis is common. Lab diagnosis is common for all viruses. So there are five ways of diagnosing any virus. There is direct microscopy, there is serology, there is PCR, that is nucleic acid detection, protein detection. So one by one we will see. And yes, virus isolation in the ag or in culture media and treatment. So these will be the common heading. Let me start the first virus, pox virus. So please start filling this table. Please take a notebook with me. Please take a pen. Please make this table and start filling this table with me. I'm starting with the first virus. The first virus for today is the pox virus. Can you see? After pox, I will start with adeno, then parvo, then papova, and then herpes, all eight herpes virus. So starting with the pox virus, these will be the headings. So pox virus morphology. Morphology, you tell me the shape. Pox virus is a brick shape. Can you see the diagram? It is a brick shape. You all can see it is brick shape. Brick shape. It is brick shape. So write down the shape. Shape is brick shape. Genetic material, of course, these all are DNA viruses. Na? So it is a DNA virus, but it is double-stranded. Only parvo is single-stranded. Rest all are double-stranded DNA. So it is double-stranded DNA virus. It is enveloped or non-enveloped? It is enveloped. The three which are non-enveloped are PAP. The other two P's, parvo, papova, and adeno. These three are non-enveloped. Rest three are enveloped. So it is enveloped. Symmetry, it is having a complex symmetry. All of them have icosahedral symmetry. Except pox virus, which is having complex symmetry. Replication of all the DNA viruses takes place in nucleus, except pox virus, in which replication takes place in cytoplasm. So complex symmetry is an exception here. Cytoplasm is an exception here. Enveloped, double-stranded, brick-shaped, yes, sab yaad karna hai. MCQ can come on any point. Please remember. So that is the morphology. You can see this is the nucleic acid at the center. Nucleic acid is double-stranded DNA. Nucleic acid is present inside a dumbbell shape. Dumbbell shape code. There is a dumbbell, you know, dumbbell. This shape is known as dumbbell shape. So it is present inside the nucleic acid is contained within a dumbbell shape code. And on either side of nucleic acid, there are two lateral bodies, one on either side, lateral bodies. So two lateral bodies on either side, a lens shaped structure is present, which is known as lateral body. Then it is the largest virus, largest DNA virus B and largest overall in the world. The largest virus is the pox virus. And among DNA, it is the largest virus. It can be seen under light microscope. Itna bada hai ki it can be seen in light microscope. Usually viruses cannot be seen under light microscope. Coming on classification, this is the classification of pox virus, you can see. So these are the viruses, among them which are important. So it is variola, vaccinia, cowpox, monkeypox, pseudo cowpox, orpox, tanapox, yaba pox, molluscum contagiosum. Many of them causes disease in animals. But only three of them causes disease in man. Man. So I will teach you only three. Which three? Variola, vaccinia, and molluscum contagiosum. So I'm going to teach you these three. Variola, vaccinia, and molluscum contagiosum. These are the three important pox virus. But classification, you should know the complete classification. So morphology ho gaya, classification ho gaya. Morphology or classification ke baad, we will start one by one. So variola, I'm starting with the variola. The first pox virus is variola. Variola is a virus which causes smallpox. The disease caused by variola is smallpox. You know, smallpox is eradicated nowadays. It doesn't occur. Abhi jo hota hai, wo chickenpox hota hai. Aur chickenpox is a herpes virus. It is not pox virus. Family hi alag hai. Smallpox yahan se hota hai. Where is the classification? This is the classification. Just a second. Let me show you. So pox virus mein variola hai. It causes smallpox. And herpes virus mein vaccinia hai. It causes chickenpox. So family hi alag hai smallpox chickenpox ki. But the lesions are almost same in both of them. So let me teach you variola virus first. It is a type of smallpox. The reservoir is human. Transmission is by respiratory route, like COVID. You know, it is by respiratory route. Just suppose there is a person. This person is having smallpox. So he will exhale the virus in the air and the another person will take the virus by respiratory route. So virus goes inside another person by respiratory route in the trachea, in the lungs. From that, the virus will enter in the blood of this person. After entering in the blood, the virus will go where? Let's see. So the virus is coming by inhalation, upper respiratory tract. First, it will go in lymphatic or in blood. It will cause viremia. And from there, it will go to skin, dermal tissue. It has a propensity to enter in dermal tissue. And it will produce lesions known as pox. The lesions are known as pox. I will show you these are the pox. Can you see this is smallpox? Can you see these are the lesions? These lesions are known as pox. So on entering the dermal tissue, it will produce a disease known as smallpox, in which the whole body is covered by lesions. The lesions are known as pox. The lesions are known as pox. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. So that is the pathogenesis. So it is entering by respiration, going to upper respiratory tract, going to lymphatics and blood, causing viremia. From blood, it is entering in dermal tissue and causing pox. Causing pox, the disease is known as smallpox. Incubation period, if you try to learn, make a list of incubation period at one place. All incubation periods should be included at one place. So 5 to 17 days is the incubation period. So when the person is having this, this is the this stage is known as rash. Patient is having rash all over the body. Before rash, he is having a prodrome. He is having a prodrome. Prodrome means he is having fever. In the prodrome, he is having fever, he is having headache, he is having flu-like symptoms. So first a prodrome occurs for 2 to 4 days, followed by rash. So there are two stages, prodrome followed by rash. Prodrome is for 2 to 4 days, in which the person is highly infective. After that, it is followed by rash. Followed by rash. Rash kahan se start hoti hai? Again, important MCQ. From where the rash is starting? Now, this portion is important in microbiology. Okay, I agree. It is also important in pathology. It is also important in PSM. So we are covering the diseases from three subjects together. So PSM se bhi pura cover ho jayega. Ye tumhara communicable diseases, respiratory communicable diseases. So I had taken the content not only from micro, not only from patho, from PSM also. So I will cover the, it will take a little bit extra time, but your three subjects will be covered regarding this topic. Have you got it? Have you got it? I will teach you BCG vaccine also here. I will teach you all vaccines also here, one by one. So, jahan pe jo relevant hai, wahan pe hum wo lete jayenge. I will teach you all vaccines also, so PSM bhi covered hota jayega. Give me a thumbs up. So, rash kahan se start hoga? It is starting from mouth. Then it will spread to face, then arms and legs, then feet, and then the entire body within 24 hours. So first, the rash start from the mouth. Again, a very important MCQ. The rash start from the mouth. The main difference between the smallpox and chickenpox. In smallpox, the rash is centrifugal. So it starts from mouth and go to the periphery. Go to the periphery. That is centrifugal, away from the center. And in contrast to this, when I will teach you chickenpox, you will see the rash is centripetal. It will start from the periphery and comes towards the center. Centrifugal and centripetal, I hope you know it. So here the rash is starting from mouth and going to the periphery. Done. Now listen, there are multiple vesicles. Now you can see this is a vesicle. Okay, let me mark. So this is a vesicle. This is a vesicle. All of them are in same stage. All of them, either they are vesicle or they are papule or they are macule. So all of them have same stage. That's why the rash is known as synchronous rash, because all the vesicles are in same stage. In contrast to chickenpox, in which rash is non-synchronous rash. Some of the lesions are macules, some of them are papules, some of them are vesicles, some of them are like this. So it is non-synchronous rash. Here it is synchronous. So you should understand the differences between smallpox and chickenpox. Done. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. You should know. Chickenpox bhi aisa hi dikhta hai. Today only, in the end of this lecture, after 1 hour, I will teach you the last topic will be chickenpox today. I guess hum wahan tak pahunch jayenge. So chickenpox, I will teach you in herpes. Herpes, varicella. It is variola. Wo varicella hai. Variola is a type of pox virus. Varicella is a type of herpes virus. Give me a thumbs up. But externally, both of them are same. So you should know the differences between chickenpox and smallpox. 5-star important question for MCQs. So chickenpox rash. Chickenpox rash appears like dewdrops. Dewdrops on a rose petal. You know, gulab ki pankuri pe os ki boonde. It is beautiful in looking. So it is not like that. Smallpox mein aisa nahi hai. It is centripetal, it is centrifugal. You know the meaning of centripetal, centrifugal now? Give me a thumbs up if you know the meaning of centripetal and centrifugal. So this is a person. This is a person. This is another person. Let me draw two persons here. And let me draw smallpox and chickenpox rash. So let me draw smallpox. This is smallpox and this is chickenpox. So smallpox start from the center and go to the periphery. Go to the periphery and go to the periphery, everywhere in the periphery. So this rash. And chickenpox start from the periphery. It starts from the periphery and come towards the center. Come towards the center. It comes towards the center. That is the distribution. So can I say smallpox rash is centrifugal, away from the center, and chickenpox rash is centripetal, towards the center. Give me a thumbs up. I tried hard. Give me a thumbs up. So chickenpox is centripetal, smallpox is centrifugal. Yes or no? As I have told you, all the lesions, whether they are in the same stage or alag-alag stage, different stage, if all of them are in same stage, it is known as non-pleomorphic rash. Non-pleomorphism nahi hai. They are in same stage. All of them are in same stage in smallpox. But in chickenpox, the rash is pleomorphic. Some of them are papule, some are pustule, some are macule, some are vesicle. So different stages at the same time. It is known as pleomorphic rash. Yes or no? In chickenpox, the rash is superficial and unilocular. If this is the lesion for chickenpox, if you burst it, only one compartment is there from inside. That is unilocular from inside. But in smallpox, if you burst it, you will see multiple compartments. Inside one of them, multiple compartments are there, and it is a deep rash. So superficial hai ki deep hai, unilocular hai ki multilocular hai, that you have to learn. In chickenpox, surrounding the rash, you find a surrounding each vesicle, you will find a reddish area, that is inflammation. But here inflammation is absent. Here inflammation is present, it is absent. Here in this diagram, you can't see any inflammation. You see only lesions. Around the lesions, I can't find any inflammation in chickenpox. The diagram, sorry, smallpox guy, done. And chickenpox affect axilla also, but not the palms and soles. Palms and soles. Mujhe chickenpox hua tha when I was a kid. So I don't have the lesions on the palms, but I was having the lesions all over the body, but not on the palms and soles. The lesion occurs in axilla also. Done. And opposite occurs in smallpox. Smallpox mein lesion affects palms and soles. You can see in this diagram, I have shown the palms. The lesions are present in the palms. It is smallpox, no? It is smallpox. But lesion never occurs in axilla. So axilla or palm and soles, aapko yaad karna hai. Yahan pe chickenpox mein, in 4 to 7 days, scabs are formed. Lesions are gone and scabs are formed. You know, scabs are the residual lesions. Done. And in smallpox, it takes 10 to 14 days for the formation of scabs. Give me a thumbs up, everyone. Everyone, very important table for MCQs. Please, everyone, mark this table. Please, everyone, mark this table. Done. It is the only disease till now, till date, which is eradicated globally. Now, you will not find even a single case of smallpox in the entire globe, on the entire earth, in the entire world, because the disease is eradicated. Till date, 2021, it is the only disease which is eradicated globally, It is eradicated, not only eliminated, it is eradicated. It is eradicated. It is not present on earth now. So it is the only one disease till date which is eradicated. Done. What is the next target for eradication? Polio. Polio ke liye, you know, kitne missions chal rahe hain. Polio, measles, gonia worm, and diphtheria. These are the four next diseases which we are targeting to eradicate, but yet now they are not eradicated. Now tell me the date when smallpox last case was seen in India and world. So last endogenous case of smallpox in India. Let's talk about India first. Then I will talk about the world. Three things about India. Three things about world. So let me talk about India. India mein last case was seen in 1975. 17 May 1975. That was the last endogenous case. Endogenous yani India ka khud ka case. After that, one case was imported. Imported from some other country. So that was on 24th, after 7 days. 24th May 1975. And that was the last case. The last endogenous case or last imported case. Both were in May 1975. So 3 years. 2 years after this, India was declared smallpox free. So India was declared smallpox free in 1977 April, just 2 years after the last case. Give me a thumbs up. That is a thing. Coming on the world. In the world, last case was seen in a place known as Somalia. Somalia. In a place known as Somalia, it was in 1977. Jab India smallpox free ho gaya, tab world ka last case aaya tha. So world ka, jab bhi last case milega, uske 2 saal baad hum declare karenge it is free. Uske baad agar ek bhi case nahi aaya to. So 1977 October mein tha, and that was the last case globally, actual last case. Uske baad ek lab accident hua tha. Due to laboratory accident, the person was infected. In the lab, the sample of smallpox was preserved, and from that contamination, the person got infected. The lab technician got infected. It was in 1978. So 2 years after it, 1980 mein, it was global eradication of smallpox. So global eradication of smallpox in 1980. If you want to learn all dates, it's good for PSM. Not in micro, but in PSM, these are asked. If you don't want to learn all, learn the last thing. when global eradication of smallpox is done. It is 8 May 1980. That is global eradication of smallpox. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone, global eradication. So India mein eradication, it is in April 1977. India mein eradication was 3 years earlier than the world eradication. World eradication baad mein hua, global eradication baad mein hua. Everyone give me a thumbs up. What is the treatment? No treatment is available, only supportive care. If the patient is having fever, give paracetamol. If the patient is having pain, give painkiller and NSAIDs. So only supportive care you can give to this person, smallpox person. Done. That is the treatment. And prevention, live attenuated vaccine is available. My parents, not exactly parents, my grandparents were vaccinated for that. Maybe my parents were vaccinated, but I'm not vaccinated because when I was born, of course, after 1980. Until 1980, it was eradicated. So government has removed the vaccine from the world because the disease is not there. So vaccine ki kya zarurat hai? So I was born. We all are born after 1980, of course. So after those who are born after 1980, they are not vaccinated for smallpox because the disease is already removed. But our parents, ask your parents. They will show you the sign here also. They will show you a, you know, mark of the smallpox. Chota chechak kehte the se. So they will show you the mark. Yes, we are vaccinated for this disease. Because at that time, at their era, the disease was there. Give me a thumbs up. So the vaccine is available, but it is not, we are not vaccinated because the disease is already eradicated. So we are done with the first variola. Variola complete ho gaya. It is a causative agent of smallpox. Hindi mein it is known as chota chechak. Done. Coming on vaccinia. The second virus. It is not actually virus. It is an artificial virus. What we have done, we have taken the variola. We have taken the variola and changed one antigen in this. Single antigen. And the virus which is created because of this, the artificial virus, it is known as vaccinia. It is used to form the vaccine for variola. Vaccinia naam mein hai vaccine. It is used for creating vaccine for smallpox. मैंने कहा ना अगर पेरेंट्स आर वैक्सीनेटेड तो वैक्सीन आई कहां से वी हैव क्रिएटेड द वैक्सीन ह्यूमंस हैव क्रिएटेड द वैक्सीन तो इट इज वेरी डेंजरस कि वैक्सीन क्रिएट करते करते द पर्सन हु इज क्रिएटिंग द वैक्सीन हु इज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग द वैक्सीन हैंडलिंग वायरस कैन कॉज स्मॉल पॉक्स टू दैट पर्सन ऑल्सो ना इट इज अ वेरी डेंजरस वायरस सो वी विल डिक्रीज द वी विल एटेन्यूएट द वायरस डिक्रीज द पैथोजेनिसिटी ऑफ द वायरस बाय चेंजिंग वन एंटीजन सो सिंगल एंटीजन चेंज इट इज अ आर्टिफिशियल वायरस इट इज नॉट अ नेचुरल वायरस द नेम इंडिकेट वैक्सीन से बना वैक्सीनिया The word vaccinia. So it is similar to variola. The two viruses differ only by single antigen. It is an artificial virus. It does not occur in nature as such. We have created it. And we have created it for manufacturing the vaccine of smallpox in that era. Give me a thumbs up. It is created by genetic recombination. And it is safer to work with vaccinia virus. So the workers, the technicians which are manufacturing in the factory, the vaccine for the smallpox, they will work with vaccinia virus. So it is relatively safer. As compared to smallpox, abhi COVID ka vaccine create kar rahe, toh we have first attenuated the virus na. The persons who are creating it, unhi ko ho gaya toh fir, have you got it? Give me a thumbs up, everyone. So that is vaccinia. So we are done with variola. We are done with vaccinia. Vaccinia mein kuch hai nahi na. It is an artificial virus which is used for vaccine. Only one antigen difference is there that you have to learn. The third virus is molluscum contagiosum in the pox viridae family. We are studying the first family pox viridae. Molluscum contagiosum. So molluscum contagiosum, the reservoir is again human. Transmission is sexual or through fomites, sexual and fomites. And again the pathogenesis, it occurs in dermis. Like smallpox, like chickenpox, it forms lesions in the dermis. These are the lesions of molluscum contagiosum. Can you see? Now there is a hallmark in this lesion. Can anyone notice that hallmark? The peculiarity. You can see the lesion. In the center of the lesion, in the center of each of them. Should I more zoom it out to show you? Okay. You can see the center is depressed. It is looking like umbilicus. You know umbilicus. So center is depressed. It is known as umbilicated lesion. So typical history. A clinical question will come in your exam. A patient is there having a viral infection. After that, he is having rash. The rash is having vesicles. Vesicles with the umbilicated. The center is depressed. With a depressed central umbilication. Give me a thumbs up. So it is like the rash is like this. It is single, multiple wart-like lesions are there. And pink, pearly, white nodule is there with an umbilicated lesion. In healthy persons, no treatment is required. In immunocompromised, you have to give ritonavir and sidofovir. So that is lab diagnosis of all of them. I'm teaching you lab diagnosis of all three viruses together. Variola, vaccinia, and molluscum contagiosum. I taught you three viruses. The diseases of three of them. So variola causes smallpox, molluscum contagiosum causes molluscum contagiosum. The name of the disease is also that only. And vaccinia do not cause any disease. It is an artificial virus. It is used for creating vaccine for the smallpox. So the three viruses in the pox viridae family are complete. The first family is complete. Now I'm telling you lab diagnosis for all of them in common. Lab diagnosis ke liye, what will be the specimen? What will be your specimen? The vesicular fluid. You know, vesicle ke andar se syringe dal ke fluid ko aspirate kar lo. The vesicular fluid. It is the specimen. You should know the specimen. It is a common sense, na? Specimen kya hoga isme? Isme only one thing is happening. Vesicles. Rash. So rash mein vesicle ke andar se syringe dal ke usko aspirate kar lo. Vesicular fluid will be the specimen. Give me a thumbs up. You do three things. Number one, us vesicular fluid ko you collect it in a test tube. In a test tube. Introduce saline in it, make the saline suspension, do the direct microscopy. In direct microscopy, you will find inclusion bodies. You know inclusion bodies, yesterday I taught you. These are cytoplasmic inclusion bodies. If it is variola, you will find pathogen bodies. If it is vaccinia, you will find Guillain-Barré bodies. If it is molluscum contagiosum, you will find Henderson-Peterson bodies, HP bodies. I have taught you three viruses. Variola, vaccinia, and molluscum contagiosum. Name the inclusion body of each of them. So variola causes pathogen bodies. Vaccinia causes Guillain-Barré bodies. And molluscum contagiosum causing Henderson-Peterson bodies. Name the bodies. These are the inclusion bodies of each of them. Or a fowl pox bhi hota hai, pox viridae family mein. Fowl pox I have not taught you because it doesn't cause diseases in humans. It causes diseases in animals. That's why I have not taught you. But it is also a pox viridae family virus. It causes Bollinger bodies. So learn these. Give me a thumbs up. So fowl pox mein, it is Bollinger bodies. Give me a thumbs up. Name. Learn the name of the inclusion bodies in each of the following viruses. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So I'm done. There, can you see? This is the Guillain-Barré body. I will show you. Okay, I will try to show you. Try to see the arrow. Okay, I will mark it for you. Can you see? This is a cell in the cytoplasm of the cell. Can you see this body? Again, this is a cell. In the cell, can you see in the cytoplasm? This is the body. These are Guillain-Barré bodies in the vaccinia. Done. That was the first thing. See the inclusion bodies in direct microscopy. Second, virus isolation. Isolation can be done in three things. I have already told you. Either in mice, in animals, mein mice ho jayega. Egg mein, there are four layers. So in embryonated egg, there are four layers. The first layer is scam. You know the four layers yesterday I taught you. It is chorioallantoic membrane. So in the chorioallantoic membrane in the egg, you know hen's egg, this is the embryo of the hen's egg. So the first outermost membrane is scam. So take your specimen in a syringe and fill it in scam. Fill it in chorioamniotic membrane and keep it for 24 hours in incubator. After that, hatch the egg. Hatch the egg, usko break kar do. Take this membrane out, chorioallantoic membrane out. And see, on the membrane, you will see the lesions. You will see the lesions. These are the pox. It is like the same pox which are on the skin of humans. So it is in the same way, like humans, it is involving egg also. It is involving the membrane of the egg. Give me a thumbs up. So it is causing pox. In 48 to 72 hours, it will produce pox and CAM. Learn the membrane. Which membrane? There are four, now CAM, that is chorioallantoic membrane, allantoic membrane, yolk sac, and amniotic membrane. So out of the four, I am injecting it in the first membrane, that is CAM. Give me a thumbs up. So it is producing pox. Pox are produced by variola also, vaccinia also. We have two viruses now, variola and vaccinia is the artificial virus of variola. So both of them will form pox, but the morphology of each of the pox is different. Variola ka pox alag honge, vaccinia ki pox alag honge. Can you see? This one is variola pox. Variola. And these are vaccinia pox. Vaccinia. So you will see, ma'am, what is the difference? We can see white dots, but what is the difference? You see, variola are small, vaccinia are large. Variola are shiny and white, convex. These are flat. Wo convex hai, ye flat hai. Wo white hai, ye grayish hai. These are non-necrotic, these are necrotic. These are non-hemorrhagic, these are hemorrhagic. So that is the difference. These are small, these are large. These are non-necrotic, non-hemorrhagic. These are necrotic, these are hemorrhagic. Give me a thumbs up. That is the pox. That is the difference between the pox you have to learn. So I'm done. I'm done with the first family, that is pox. Pox viridae. In pox viridae, I taught you three viruses. Name the three viruses which I taught you in pox viridae. Pox viridae, variola, vaccinia, molluscum contagiosum. There are six viruses, but three are important for human diseases. Rest three causes diseases on animals. I have not taught you that. Everyone give me a thumbs up. You know the morphology. You know the classification. You know reservoir are human. Transmission is respiratory route. Pathogenesis after respiratory route is it is going in lymph node. It is lymphatic blood and then dermis. In the dermis, it is producing lesions known as pox. Name the diseases. Variola causes smallpox. Molluscum contagiosum causes molluscum contagiosum. Vaccinia do not cause any disease. It is used for vaccine. Lab diagnosis I have taught you. Treatment I have taught you. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I need thumbs up from each of you. Please make this comparative table. That is my advice to you. So out of the DNA virus, the first DNA virus is over. Pox. Pox me teen virus khatam. Khatam. I have explained you everything. On what points MCQs can be asked, I have explained you everything. My notes are more than sufficient to read for your FMG exam. And just read my notes. All the MCQs from this portion will be from my notes only that I can challenge. Whether it is a repeat MCQ, whether it is a new MCQ, it will be from my notes. Watch my lectures carefully and please read my notes. And whatever high yielding points, tables I'm asking you to make it in a high yielding notebook that you will revise at the end of the day. The questions will be from my notes, but you will be able to take the correct answer only in the last day of your exam preparation. If you go in the exam revising these notes, if you don't revise these notes, now there is no use of listening these lectures. So you have to compile all notes together in one notebook. In the end, last 10 days, one or two notebooks are there that you have to revise. So that's why I always say take a paper and notebook with you. So whatever important you find that this I should revise at the last day, you should write it. And at the same moment, you should enter it. Done. Baad mein kabhi nahi aata. Have you got it? So I'm done with the pox reading. I'm coming on the second virus for today's adenovirus. So these are the six DNA viruses I have to teach you. I'm coming on adenovirus. Give me a thumbs up. I'm a little bit fast, I know, but I have to. So again, the same headings. Morphology. What is the shape? Iska shape kya tha? Iska shape tha brick shape. Iska shape kya hai? Iska shape hai spacecraft. I will show you spacecraft. So space vehicle. You know, this is, can you see? It is looking like a space vehicle. Yes or no? So it is looking like Apollo or, you know, it is looking like a space vehicle. So it is looking like this external appearance of space vehicle. What is the genetic material? Of course, it is a DNA virus. All of them are double-stranded except parvo, which is single-stranded. I'm teaching you adeno. It is also double-stranded. Enveloped, non-enveloped? It is non-enveloped. Three of them are non-enveloped. Conce three? It is adeno, parvo, and pepova. These three are non-enveloped. Rest all of them are enveloped. So it is non-enveloped, as I have already told you. Symmetry? All of them have icosahedral symmetry except pox, which is having complex symmetry. So it is having icosahedral symmetry. Replication, all of them replicate in nucleus except pox, which replicate in cytoplasm. So again, it is the nucleus. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone, thumbs up, fast dete jana hai. Fast, done. That is adenovirus. Let me tell you, there are, you know, there is nucleic acid at the center. All viruses have double-stranded DNA at the center and it is surrounded by capsid. The capsid is made up of capsomer. Capsid is a protein. It is made up of monomer. The monomer is capsomer. How many capsomers are present here? Learn the number, it is 252. Again, an important MCQ. Can you, if you count these now, these blue color circles, these are capsomers and these are 252 in number. Out of 252, 240 and 12, total 252. These 12, the 12 one are present in the form of the stick. Count, these are 12 sticks. Please, you can count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 are present in the form of apical fiber with a knob at the apex. So it is giving the appearance, these are 12. And bache hue 240. 240 are forming these triangles. These are the triangles of icosahedral symmetry. These are forming the triangles. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So total, first tell me the genetic material. It is double-stranded DNA. Double-stranded DNA surrounded by capsid. Capsid is made up of capsomer. Total 252 capsomers are there. Out of the 252, 240 plus 12. These 12 are forming the apical fibers with a knob at the apex. Apical fibers giving appearance of spacecraft. And these 240 are forming the triangles of icosahedral symmetry. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So that is spacecraft, space vehicle, space vehicle appearance. So there is a 12 of them are forming a rod-like portion with a knob at the distal end. You have seen it. This is the knob at the distal end and a fiber. These are 12. These are 12 in number. These are capsomers. They have the capacity to carry DNA from one organism to another and these are used for gene therapy. So these are potential vectors or vehicles for the gene therapy. Done. Learn it. It is important for genetic engineering. These are important. Classification, you don't have to learn this classification actually, but I will tell you there are seven species. So it is A, B1, B2, C, D, E, F, G. in each of them there are serotypes, total 52 serotypes are there. Now don't learn ki A mein kaun se wale hain, 12, 18 and 31, B1 mein kaun se hain, don't learn it. So total 52 serotypes are there. There are 7 species A to G and there are 1 to 52 serotypes which are divided in the species. Give me a thumbs up. So that is the classification, total 52 serotypes divided in 8 species. 8 species are A to G. In sab mein ye 52 serotypes are divided. Give me a thumbs up, that is the classification. Reservoir is humans also, animals also. Transmission is respiratory also, picoral also. So pathogenesis, as soon as adenovirus enters in the body, either through conjunctiva or through nasal road or through oral road. So any route it is entering, after incubation of 5 to 7 days in that organ, particular organ, it will enter inside. It will enter inside and it will enter in the lymph node. It will enter in the lymph node and from lymph node it will cause the disease. In adults, it causes ARDS. Acute respiratory distress syndrome. Acute respiratory distress. It can cause conjunctivitis also. It can cause acute hemorrhagic cystitis in the bladder. And it can cause gastroenteritis, that is diarrhea also. So these are the diseases caused by it. Now you have to learn which serotype causes which disease. This table, you have to learn. So respiratory disease in children is caused by 1256. Sore throat, ARDS in adults is caused by 4721. Okay, if you don't want to learn all these, learn only important one, the two types of conjunctivitis, the follicular conjunctivitis or epidemic keratoconjunctivitis. These are the two types of conjunctivitis in eye. Now this question is not from micro, this question is from ophthal. If you study ophthal, you know the two types of conjunctivitis. So these two are type of conjunctivitis, you have to learn the serotype. So follicular conjunctivitis is caused by 3 and 7. And keratoconjunctivitis, epidemic keratoconjunctivitis is caused by 8, 19 and 37. So, ye dono to learn karne hi padenge. Please learn it. Or cystitis bhi specific hai, 11 or 21. So, I know it is difficult. You will ask, ma'am, ye kaise learn karenge? So, sab mat karo na. Don't learn the complete table. Learn these two conjunctivitis and learn this hemorrhagic cystitis on which MCQs are asked frequently. So, you have to learn these serotypes. That is the diseases. Kaunsa serotype, kaunsa? Total 52 serotypes hain. Main sabka to nahi bata rahi, all 52. But the important ones are these. You have to learn. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone, I am not teaching you the 52, the each and every serotype. But important one you have to learn. These are the diseases caused by them. And which serotype is causing each of these corresponding diseases. That you have to learn. So if you read it twice or thrice now, you will be able to learn it. So the two type of conjunctivitis are really important. These two. Acute follicular and keratoconjunctivitis and hemorrhagic cystitis is important. As according to me, on these three, the questions are already asked in PYQs of various exams. So these three, the question aa chuke hain. Kisi aur mein se aa jaye to I don't know. Maybe it can come from other diseases also. So better to go with the complete table. If you are unable to read it completely, learn it completely, then at least learn these three. On which PYQs are already there, you can't afford to miss it. Done. Should I proceed ahead? Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So it is serotype 1 to 8 which causes maximum infections out of 52, 1 to 8. And from A to G, maximum infections are from C, serotype C. So maximum kismet hain, that you have to learn. From 52, 1 to 52, maximum are from 1 to 8. And from A to G, maximum are from C. So that is all about it. Blood diagnosis same. Specimen can be multiple now. If it is causing respiratory tract infection, it can be throat swab, nasopharyngeal swab, bronchial lavage. If it is causing conjunctivitis, it can be conjunctival swab. It can be corneal swab in the eye. If it is causing cystitis, it will be urine. It is causing diarrhea, it will be anal swab. It can be gastric secretion. It can be biopsy. So multiple specimens depending what is the disease. There is a variety of disease now. So that's why specimens are also multiple. Do the direct microscopy as usual. Do virus isolation. It is not done in ag. It is done in tissue cultures. And do PCR. Do PCR is the most sensitive. Do serology. You know, serology, we don't search virus. We search antibodies against virus in the blood. So these are the same lab diagnosis that I have told you in general. Treatment is nothing special. Prevention, there is a vaccine available for it. Vaccine is available. I'm done with the second virus also. So I'm done with pox virus. In pox virus, I taught you three virus. Variola, vaccinia, molluscum contagiosum. After that, I started with adenovirus. So adenovirus, only one, there is a classification, but classification 1 to 52 serotypes are there. So we have not studied individual virus. As a whole, adenovirus is done. So all these headings for pox virus also, you know, for adenovirus also, you know, and I hope you are filling this table with me. So should I come on the third virus? Third, I will teach you. We are done with pox. We are done with adeno. I'm coming on parvovirus, the smallest virus, smallest DNA virus, smallest overall virus. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Every one of you, please give me a thumbs up. So I'm coming on parvovirus, the third virus. The two are already done. These are the headings under which we will discuss. So I'm starting the third virus, parvo. We are done with pox, done with adeno. I'm coming on parvovirus. In pox, there were three viruses. Remember, adeno mein alag se subtype nahi hai. Parvo mein there is no classification. Only one virus is there in parvovirus viridi family, parvovirus 19. Only one virus is there. So there is no complete classification. Only one virus is there. So I'm starting with parvovirus. Parvovirus says, tell me the morphology. There is no particular shape. So in pox virus, particular shape was brick shape. In adenovirus, particular shape was space vehicle, spacecraft. Yes or no? In parvovirus, there is no particular shape. Yeah, the important thing, it is the smallest virus. Can you see it is the smallest one? Smallest virus. And it is the overall DNA may be smallest. Overall DNA plus RNA may be smallest. So it is the overall smallest also. RNA may be smallest. Smallest ki teen cheezein batao. Smallest virus. Among the DNA, which is the smallest virus? Among the RNA, which is the smallest virus? Among overall, which is the smallest? Who will tell me answer of these three fast? DNA में से कौन है? कौन है? अभी बताया मैंने पार्वो. RNA में से कौन है? Which is the smallest virus among RNA? It is picorna. And overall कौन है? इन दोनों में से भी ज़्यादा small कौन है? पार्वो picorna में से कौन है? So again it is parvo. So that you have to learn the three smallest, the three largest. You should learn three largest also. ऐसे ही three largest का बताओ. Who will tell me largest में भी तीनों चीजें बताओ. Largest DNA virus कौन है? Largest RNA virus कौन है? और largest overall कौन है? Who will tell me the answers? So largest DNA is pox, largest RNA is paramyxo, and overall in dono mein se bhi largest kaun hai? Pox or paramyxo mein se. So again it is pox. So this is the largest with 3 MCQs, smallest with 3 MCQs that you have to learn. Done. Give me a thumbs up. So it is the smallest virus. We are studying parvovirus. It is the smallest. Done. It is having, okay, listen, one more thing. All DNA viruses have double-stranded DNA. Only parvovirus is the exception, which is having single-stranded. It is very small, na? It can't double I nahi payega. So that's why God has given single-stranded DNA to it. Rest, all of them have double-stranded DNA. These are DNA viruses, but DNA bhi double hai ki single hai. So it is having single-stranded DNA. It is the only DNA virus with single-stranded DNA. It is enveloped or non-enveloped? I told you it is non-enveloped. The three enveloped, both dusre hain. Done. It is having icosahedral symmetry. All of them having icosahedral symmetry except pox, which is having complex symmetry. All of them replicate in nucleus except pox, which replicate in cytoplasm. So replication occurs in nucleus. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. That is the morphology of parvo. Morphology ke baad hum aayenge classification. There is no classification. Only one important virus is parvovirus B19. Parvovirus B19, only one virus in this family is there. So there is no classification as such. This is where the human hai, transmission respiratory hai, trans placental is also there. If a pregnant lady is having parvovirus infection, the virus can go via placenta to the fetus and causes diseases in the fetus also. That is known as trans placental or vertical route. Done. Pathogenesis. So what it will do, you know, in the bone marrow, hematopoiesis takes place. So this is the cell which is known as hematopoietic stem cell. From this cell only, erythroid precursor, myeloid precursor will be formed. And that will form RBCs, WBCs, platelets, everything will be formed. So erythroid precursor have a receptor on it. This is the erythroid precursor. Erythroid progenitor have a precursor on it, which is known as P antigen. So this parvovirus, it is entering in human body. Just suppose I'm the human body. It is entering in human body via respiratory route. After going in the trachea, in the lungs, it will go in the blood. From the blood, it will go to the bone marrow. From the bone marrow, there are numerous cells in the bone marrow. It will affect erythroid progenitor KP receptor, so the virus will bind and just inhibit it, just destroy this receptor. So RBCs will not form. WBC will be formed, platelet will be formed, but RBC will not form. So patient will have aplastic crisis. The disease known as is PRCA, pure red cell aplasia. Only red cell aplasia is there. Pancytopenia is not there. WBC are formed normally. Platelet are formed normally, but RBCs are not formed. So patient will have severe anemia. Give me a thumbs up, because this virus is binding with the P antigen present on the erythroid progenitor in the bone marrow. The virus is destroying the erythroid progenitor. Our cells are destroyed. Lysis burst ho jayenge, and it will produce, because RBCs are not produced, patient will have anemia. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone. So diseases children mein kaun si hogi, disease fetus mein kaun si hogi, disease adults mein kaun si hogi. So fetus, children, adult. First I will tell you children, then adult, then fetus in the end. So fetus mein kahan se aayega? Through trans placental route. Or children or adult mein kahan se aayega? Via respiratory route. So route is different. Here fetus mein root is vertical or transplacental. Here roots are respiratory. Done. So in children, it causes a disease known as fifth disease. You have to make a table: fifth disease, sixth disease, seventh disease. So it is fifth. Fifth disease, also known as slap cheek. You know, slap yani chanta marna. Hindi mein. So disease looks like this. Aisa lagta hai bacche ko kisi ne zor se ek chanta mara hai. So the cheek become red. So that is known as slapped. Slapped cheek disease, also known as fifth disease, also known as erythema infectiosum. Erythema because it is red, redness. Erythema infectiosum. It is due to the infection of parvovirus. Give me a thumbs up. Learn three names. Learn three names. What are the three names? Slap cheek disease, fifth disease, erythema infectiosum. All of them are caused by parvovirus B19. Parvovirus B19 in children, not in adults. In children, not in adults. Can you see? Slap cheek disease. Fifth disease, erythema infectiosum. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So here, patient first have flu-like symptoms followed by indurated facial rash. So it is like facial rash. Typically, vasodilatation of the blood vessels of the cheek. It is looking like slap. Sleeping, slap. It is looking like slap cheek. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone, I'm waiting for your thumbs up. Yeah, come on. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Done. In adults, it causes rash along with arthralgia. The rash is non-specific. Arthralgia first involves the wrist joint. So in adults, it causes arthralgia, joint pain. And in fetus, it causes severe anemia. So fetus sometimes dead, born dead. So it is death in utero due to the severe anemia. Fetus born having severe anemia, or fetus will have congenital heart failure. Fetus will be dead. That is hydrocephalus, and fetus will be aborted because of the severe anemia and jaundice. Done. So that is in the fetus. So three things are there in children: what it causes, in adults what it causes, and in fetus what it causes. Name the diseases. Who will tell me the diseases? In children, it is known as fifth disease, or also known as erythema infectiosum, also known as slapped cheek disease. In adults, it causes arthritis, especially in the wrist joint. Is pe MCQ aa chuka hai. Option mein tumhe fifth disease bhi denge aur arthritis bhi denge. Adult mein pucha hai to go for arthritis. Hyper excited hoke fifth disease mat laga dena. Adults mein wo bachchon mein hai. And in fetus, it causes hydrocephalus or severe anemia or death in utero. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Lab diagnosis you can do. You can take. This parvovirus B19 is difficult to grow on the culture media, so it is unable to grow. We are unable to do the isolation. We can do electron microscopy, we can do PCR, we can do the serology also. Treatment supportive care, in some treatment supportive care. I'm done with pox, I'm done with adeno, I'm done with parvo. Parvo mein only one virus was there, parvovirus B19 parvovirus. Adeno mein only one is there. Adenovirus ki multiple serotypes 1 to 52 were there. In general, I taught you all. And pox virus mein there were three virus: variola, vaccinia, and molluscum contagious. And I'm coming on the fourth virus, Papova virus. Give me a thumbs up, yaar. Come on, fast. So I'm coming on the fourth virus, Papova. It is having three virus combination. Papova. I will tell you the full form of Papova. Anyways, Papova virus morphology. There is no specific shape. So specific shape sirf do ka hi tha. Pox ka tha brick shape, or adeno ka tha space vehicle shape. And others do not have any specific shape. Genetic material, it is DNA. It is non-invert. It is having icosahedral symmetry. And it replicates in nucleus except pox virus. All of them replicate in nucleus. Done, I have told you. So you know the morphology of them. So this is the Papova virus. Papova is a three virus. It is a single thing containing three viruses. Papova. So the term pa includes papilloma virus. It is important. Huh? Human papilloma virus, HPV. Human papilloma, I'm not asking about HSV. It is HPV virus. Jo warts karega, hai na? HPV, human, this is most important. Po is polyoma virus, and va is vacillating virus. Vacillating virus animals mein disease karta hai, humans mein karta hai nahi hai. Polyoma virus renal transplant ka rejection karta hai. Renal transplanted patients mein karta hai. So you have to learn the full form. Papova. So what is the full form of Papova virus? This is the, have you known? Do you know this full form before this? So papilloma virus, polyoma virus, vacillating virus. Give me a thumbs up. So I will teach you these three viruses. It is very easy. I will teach you in short because it is not very important. So I will teach you short. So first, vacillating to chhod do. It causes diseases in animals. So hume padhna hi nahi hai. Hume do hi padhna hai. We have to study only two: papilloma and polyoma. Vacillating hume nahi padhna hai. So papilloma and polyoma. polyoma mein again two viruses are there, simian virus 40 and BK and JB virus, BK JB, total three virus polyoma mein. Polyoma mein there are three viruses and papilloma virus, HPV virus. Let me talk about papilloma first, papilloma, uske baad main polyoma pe bhi aungi. और तीसरा वैक्यूलेटिंग हमें नहीं पढ़ना, इट कॉजेस डिजीज इन एनिमल्स नॉट इन ह्यूमंस, डन. सो एचपीवी, एचपीवी, एचपीवी एंटर्स थ्रू द स्किन, थ्रू द म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन. नाउ एचपीवी हैव टू जीन्स, E6 एंड E7. सो लिसन, दिस इज अ ह्यूमन सेल, दिस इज अ ह्यूमन स्किन सेल, दिस इज द न्यूक्लियस ऑफ द स्किन सेल. All nucleus contain DNA. So it also contains DNA. DNA contains chromosome. The 23 pairs of chromosome, 46 chromosomes are present. When this virus enters in human cell, in the skin cell, it will go. It, this virus is having two proteins, E6 protein and E7 protein. So after going in the cell, the virus will form its protein, E6 and E7. This is the virus, HPV virus. It will form E6 protein and E7 protein. So E6 and E7, both of them will enter in the nucleus. In the nucleus, E6 will inhibit P53. It will cause mutation of P53 gene. And E7 will cause mutation of retinoblastoma gene. Retin, both of them are tumor suppressor gene. It will result in neoplasia. So HPV virus causes neoplasia. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. So you have to learn E6 and E7. These are the two proteins inside HPV virus which causes mutation of two human genes. E6 causes mutation of P53, E7 causes mutation of retinoblastoma. You know, P53 is present on chromosome number 17 and retinoblastoma is present on chromosome number 11. So, in specific chromosome, specific gene ko mutate karte hain. They cause mutation and inhibition of the gene. Give me a thumbs up which will lead to neoplasia. Which will lead to neoplasia. E6 inhibit P53, E7 inhibit retinoblastoma. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. You can see here also. E6, HPV ka E6 inhibiting P53 and E7 is inhibiting retinoblastoma. Along with it, one more gene is also inhibited. P53 and TERT, these two are inhibited by E6 and retinoblastoma and P21 are inhibited by E7. But important are P53 and retinoblastoma. That's why instead of four, I have taught you two genes. Done. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up. It will result in neoplasia. It will result in neoplasia, benign and malignant. If you talk about benign, it is known as VARTS. It is known as VARTS. You know, VARTS are there. So VARTS are of three types. VARTS are of three types. These are the three type of VARTS. They can occur on the fingers. They can occur on the fingers. It is known as verruca vulgaris. They can occur on the soles and feet. These are known as verruca plantaris. Vulgaris plantaris. And they can occur on the face. These are known as verruca plana. So see, this is verruca vulgaris. It is on the finger. It is on the sole. It is known as verruca plantaris. And it is on the face, behind the ear. It is known as verruca plana. Give me a thumbs up. So three type of warts are there. Along with it, anogenital warts are also known as, which are known as condyloma accumulata, important MCQ. It is caused by HPV 6 and 11. You can see on the genital region, anogenital region, these are the warts. Can you see around the vulva, these are the warts. So these are the warts. These are the warts. And the third are larynx, in the larynx also. So three type of warts. Warts are there. I will summarize it. And in neoplasia, the benign one are 6 and 11 and malignant one are 16 and 18. They causes neoplasia in the cervix of the female. So it is cervix mein benign CIN hai aur malignant mein cancer hai. Give me a thumbs up. Okay, let me summarize. I am teaching you papova virus. Papova. In papova virus, there are three viruses. Papilloma, polyoma and vaccinia. Vaccinia name, vacuolating virus. Vaculating causes diseases in animals, so chhod do, hume do hi padhne hai, papilloma and polyoma. Polyoma is of three types. I will teach you after this. First, take papilloma. Papilloma is also known as human papilloma virus, HPV. Now, take this HPV. HPV is of various serotypes. I don't know exactly the number of serotypes, but it is of various serotypes. Now, this HPV virus is having two proteins inside it, E6 and E7. After entering in human cell, E6 inhibit P53 and E7 inhibit retinoblastoma gene in human. So these genes are inhibited, so it will result in neoplasia. Neoplasia. Give me a thumbs up. Now, what diseases it is causing? So HPV virus causes neoplasia. So it causes warts. It causes warts. It causes neoplasia, low risk neoplasia and high risk neoplasia. So I will tell you warts. Warts are of three types. Skin warts, anogenital warts and laryngeal warts. Skin warts mein again three types: verruca vulgaris, verruca plantaris, verruca plana. Vulgaris on the finger, plantaris is on the soles and feet, and plana is on the face. And anogenital region and larynx, these are the words. Low risk neoplasia, it causes sin, and high risk neoplasia, it causes cancer in cervix. Sin and cancer in cervix, you have to learn the serotypes. Sin is caused by 6 and 11, again an important MCQ, and cancer cervix is caused by 16 and 18. These are the serotypes. You have to learn 6 and 11 are low risk serotype. They cause benign disease, and 16 and 18 are high risk serotype, which causes malignant lesion. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. That is a summary of HPV. That is a summary of HPV. Lead diagnosis, you know. You know, treatment, you know. Yes, a wart ka na aapko ye karwana padta hai. The treatment is cryosurgery. You know, this is a wart. It is a cryosurgery. Liquid nitrogen is given at a temperature of, minus 100 or minus 120 degrees Celsius. Pe, it is treated. So that is cryotherapy, electrocautery, chemical, or topically, we have to use these chemicals. That is the treatment. Preventionally, vaccine is available. HPV vaccine is available. So HPV vaccine for cervix cancer, it should be given to all females. There are two types of HPV vaccine. Quadrivalent, which gives protection against 6-11 also, 16-18 also. So low risk, high risk, dono ke liye protection milega. And bivalent contains only 16-18, that is only high risk. Sin ke liye protection nahi milega, cervix carcinoma ke liye protection milega. So all the females aged between 9 to 26 young girls, they should get vaccinated. They should get vaccinated. Route of efficacy, percentage is more than 90%. And three doses are to be given, 0, 2 months, 6 months. Give me a thumbs up. All of them are intramuscular doses. So that is the vaccine. That was about papilloma. Coming on polyoma. Now coming on po virus. Polyoma virus. So polyoma virus is having two viruses, BK virus and JC virus. So these are not important. Only this table you have to learn. BK virus causes renal disease in AIDS patient, and JC virus causes PML in AIDS patient. That is progressive myelofocal leukoencephalopathy, PML in AIDS. Both of them are causing disease in AIDS patient. So that is polyoma virus. So polyoma virus is important in immunosuppression, not normally. Lab diagnosis, you know, nothing important. So I'm done with this virus also. Till now, what we have done? We are done with pox virus. There are three pox virus: variola, vaccinia, molluscum contagiosum. We are done with papova virus. Papova mein there are three virus. Papova. Va we have not studied. Papova mein HPV we have studied. Pova mein BC and JC virus. What disease they are causing in AIDS patient we have studied. Parvovirus mein only one virus is there, B19, which we have studied. Adenovirus mein we have studied. 1 to 52 serotypes are there. Adenovirus we have studied. Can you know the name of diseases in each of them? What is important in each of them? Root in each of them? Pathogenesis in each of them? Mainly morphology in each of them. Which is the smallest? Which is the largest? What is the symmetry? These are the MCQs on which questions are coming in your exam. Give me a thumbs up. The next virus which I am going to teach you is herpes virus. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I want thumbs up from everyone. So next virus is herpes virus. Herpes virus, it is also a double-stranded DNA. It is involved. It is having icosahedral symmetry and it replicates in the nucleus. You already know the morphology now. Now, morphology mein, it is having 162 capsomer. You know, this is the capsomer. I'm sorry, this is not capsomer. This is the nucleic acid in the center. This is the capsid containing capsomer. It contains 162. Learn the number. In adeno, it was 252. In adeno, they were 252. And here it is 162. 162 capsomer is there and it is having an envelope. Can you see the envelope is present? On the envelope, papillomas are present. You know what are papillomas? Papillomas are present. And between capsid and envelope, you can see a pink color material. Can you see this pink color material? This is known as tegument. Tegument is present. A pink color acellular material is present, which is known as tegument. Remember, these are the eight types of HPV, HSV virus, which I have to teach you, herpes virus. So herpes virus is of eight type. Herpes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So herpes 1, 2, 3. One is HSV 1. Two is HSV 2. Three is variola zoster. Sorry. Varicella zoster. Variola nahi hai, ye varicella. Teen bhi hai. Please remember. Variola, vaccinia, varicella. Variola and vaccinia pox viridine mein hai. Or this one, that is varicella. Ye aapka herpes family mein. ये हर्पीस टाइप थ्री, गिव मी अ थम्स अप. दिस विल कॉज चिकन पॉक्स, दिस विल कॉज स्मॉल पॉक्स, दिस इज द वैक्सीन फॉर स्मॉल पॉक्स. विदाउट एनी कंफ्यूजन द थ्री बीज, वेरियोला, वैक्सीनिया एंड वेरीसेला. हैव यू रिमेंबर्ड? वेरियोला, वेरियोला, वैक्सीनिया, वैक्सीनिया एंड वेरीसेला, वेरीसेला. विदाउट एनी कंफ्यूजन these two are pox family and this is herpes 3. herpes family mein 3 number ka hai, herpes family. this will cause smallpox, this is the vaccine for smallpox, it is an artificial virus, and this will cause chickenpox. any confusion, any confusion? most of the students always have confusion between v v v. so there are 3 v, huh? so the third is varicella zoster virus, this is 3. 4 number is epstein barr virus. 5 number is cytomegalovirus. 6 number is herpes lymphotropic virus, hlv, lymphotropic virus. 7 is herpes, human herpes virus, HHV7. 8 is Kaposi sarcoma virus. So you have to name, pehle to name yaad karo aathon ka. It is HPV, sorry, not HPV. It is herpes virus. Herpes virus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Can you help me naming? So it is human herpes simplex virus 1, one number. Herpes simplex virus 2. 3 is varicella zoster, variola nahi, vaccinia nahi, varicella zoster, 3 number. 4 is epstein barr virus. 5th is cytomegalovirus, give me a thumbs up. 8 one is kaposi sarcoma virus. ab bachi baat 6 or 7 ki, 6 one is human lymphotropic virus, and 7 is human herpes virus number 7, HHV7. Give me a thumbs up. So I have to teach you all 8 viruses one by one. So my suggestion to you, to make a comparative table between them and write only diseases caused by them. Only diseases are important. Morphology to sabki maine in common bata di, pathogenesis in sabka common bata diya, lab diagnosis common kar lenge, diseases of each of them is different. You have to learn these 8 viruses differently. Have you got it? So all 8 are important, especially the first 5. That is HSV1, HSV2, varicella, EBV, and CMV. These 5 are must know the diseases by each of them. All of them are herpes virus. It is a DNA virus. So all of them are DNA viruses. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. This is a way to study virology. Done. If we are done with these 8 viruses, na, after that only one virus is remaining, Hepedna, then DNA viruses are complete. DNA to sirf 6 hi hote hain. Iske baad I will come on RNA viruses. So I'm not teaching you these 8 viruses now. I will take these 8 viruses in the next lecture. After that, I will move on RNA virus in the next lecture only. In the RNA viruses, the first virus which I will teach you is polio, picorna, that is polio virus, picorna virus. After that, I will teach you rabies. And after that, I will teach you retro, that is HIV virus. So I think these 3 are important, or something else is also there. So I will see if something else is also important. So it will take 1 or 2 more lecture and complete virology, cover to cover, general, all DNA, all RNA will be done from my side. Then I will move on bacteriology and parasitology. So in the next 7-8 days or maybe 10 days, complete microbiology is done for your competitive exam. That is FMG which we are targeting. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I'm stopping here. My next lecture is just after 10 minutes at 10:15 sharp. 10:15 sharp, I will teach you pharmacology. Don't dare to miss it. I'm going to teach you DOTS. I'm going to teach you anti-tubercular agents, ATA. So anti-tubercular drugs, the 5 drugs, HRZDS. After HRZDS, I will teach you the regimen of DOTS. After that, the treatment of MDR-TB, the treatment of XDR-TB. So don't dare to miss it. It is a 5-star important topic. So see you all. Join another link. That is anti-tubercular agents wala link. And at 10:15, have a cup of coffee, tea, come back, refresh yourself. So I'm ending this link. Join another link, everyone.